So we see in our original scripture, and I will read the second part of it again for the book of Jeremiah, chapter 15, verse 16. Thy words were found, and I did eat them, and thy word was unto me the joy and rejoicing of my heart.
Ang imong pulong ako nakaplagan, ako kining ginataon, ug ang imong mga pulong managahatag og kalipay sa akong hunahuna ug sa akong kasing-kasing.
For I am called by thy name.
Kaya ako gitawag sa imong ngalan.
Amen. So this scripture links, brings together the importance by the name by which we are called.
So kining mao nga mga pulong mga igsoon, importante gyud kayo sa katapusan nga ato imong ginawa.
So it brings together the importance of the name and the word of God.
Importante gyud kayo kanato ang pangalan ug ang pulong sa Dios.
Can everyone say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Jeremiah said that his word, God's word, was to him a joy and a rejoicing of his heart.
Si Jeremiah nagasulti nga ang pulong sa Dios alang kaniya igsoon kini mo ay kalipay ug naglipay diha sa iyang kasing-kasing.
The word is very important.
Ang pulong sa Dios pinaka importante.
The Bible, the written word of God is important.
Ang sinulat nga pulong sa Dios importante gayon.
And that is why each family should have a Bible.
Mahinong dali ang matagpamilya na naabitay sa Biblia mga igsoon.
The word spoken by the preacher.
Ang mga pulong ang isulti sa mga magwawali.
Whether a pastor or an evangelist or a teacher is important.
O matutudlo man siya, o pastor, o evangelist man siya, ang pulong ang isulti, itudlo, importante.
But as well as the prophetic word of God.
Kini maoy mga pulong soon nga gikan kinukad sa Ginoo soon.
Whether it be in the service addressing everyone,
that is nasa ang serbisyo nga atong ginahimo,
or to a person one on one, it is important.
O bisan din kinalaman ang mga tao mga igsoon nga nagaisod sa pulong sa Dios importante kana.
The gifts of the Spirit are very important.
O ang Espiritu sa Ginoo, ang gasa sa Espiritu sa Ginoo importante sa.
Letting God speak to us can reveal sin.
Og tugutan nato ang Dios pag-exulti ka nato exulti pagpahayag sa sala.
It can convict the sinner.
O kini magakondikto sa makasasala.
It can reveal many things through a word of wisdom or knowledge.
O kini magapahayag sa daghang mga butang sa mga pulong sa kahibalo o kaalam.
We need the gifts of the Spirit in every service.
Nagkinahanglan kita sa Espiritu sa Ginoo sa matag serbisyo.
Not just in Holy Ghost experts and conferences.
Dili lamang sa panahon sa mga konferensya.
But in each of our services, hallelujah.
Apan sa matag serbisyo na ito.
We need the supernatural word of God, hallelujah.
Nagkinahanglan kita sa mga pulong ngayon sa Ginoo.
Can everyone say amen?
Praise the Lord.
And all this should be a joy.
O karon mo isa ka kalipay.
They should be a rejoicing.
O kini, kung kita mga kalipay.
They should be received with gladness and openness.
O ba ang kamaya?
Because we are called by His name. Hallelujah.
Kaya tawag kita sa iyong pangalan.
We've been baptized in His name.
Kaya tawag kita sa iyong pangalan. And I can expect my
baptized.
O kaya sulti sa nagkalay
ko. We are the temple of God.
Kita ang templo sa Balaan ng Espiritu sa atong Ginoo. Hallelujah.
Jesus said, where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst of them. So that means He can be up in the midst of us, in the middle of us, anywhere.
Bisan asa na asya sa pagkaliwa.
Not just in Sunday service.
Dili lamang sa Domingo.
Not just in midweek Bible study.
Dili lamang sa akong Bible study sa tuwang.
But when we pray with our families at home.
Apalisan pa sa akong pamilya sa na mag-aampo kita Ginoo ana at taliwala.
And I encourage that for every family.
O mo ka na ang maayuhan to sa matag pamilya.
Of course, we have to pray alone in our prayer closets. alone in our prayer closets. But also, we have to pray. It's a good idea to pray with our families. I encourage that for everyone. Hallelujah. It brings a family closer. This wasn't in my message, but I did talk about it last week in Tabano. What happened between when I came back here back in
2005?
When my wife and I started to evangelize her family in Lady Lady. Actually, it was in Butuzon, if anybody knows where that is. Butuzon. So, we started out having
daily
prayer meetings.
In
my brother-in-law's house. And in one of our first prayer meetings, we made a circle and laid hands and called on the name of Jesus. And two of my nephews-in-laws received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Father. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
And I'm not saying that just to make, this is not to make myself look good, but what can happen if you minister, if you pray with your family? What can happen? So in the next couple, so a day or two after that, I wanted to borrow a church there in the bookend to have a service the next Sunday. So we invited my wife's cousin over to ask him if he could use the little church on the farm.
Praise the Lord. Yung nagutom na iso na usan ng kasin may tungod sa ilang mga servisyo.
But before my cousin-in-law left, we asked if we could pray for him and lay hands on him. Because his hand was like this.
Sigaw.
So my wife and I, we laid hands on him and prayed with him in the name of Jesus. And he was healed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. His hand straightened out. God's going to confirm your word with signs and wonders. Praise God. Can we lift the Lord up right now?
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.